We're going to work on the pKa of an indicator. And so I'm going to start by setting up the software. I have my spectrophotometer plugged in. We're going to look at the absorbance of the full length spectrum. So we're waiting for the lamp to warm up. I'm going to add my unknown indicator into three separate cuvettes. So I've already pipetted in 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid, 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide, and a buffer with the appropriate pH. And the buffer that we're going to be using is a buffer of 6.4, pH of 6.4. Okay, so we're going to pipette in. Our unknown buffer into each of these cuvettes. So it is important that you record the colors of your acid, your buffer, and your base, because you're going to be using these colors in order to determine what your unknown indicator is. Okay. All right, so now that our software has warmed up, it says we want to place a blank cuvette into the device. So I have filled a blank cuvette with water. We want to make sure the clear sides of the cuvette are lined up with the lamp. So the lamp is on this side and the detector is on the other. We click finish calibration and it is all done calibrating our instrument. We're going to start with our buffer. And we do want to make sure that this is mixed well, so I'm going to put a cap on top, shake it up, make sure the clear sides of my cuvette have no fingerprints on them, and place it into my spectrophotometer. We're going to collect our data. We click collect. After a few seconds, we hit stop and we rename this data set, and I'm going to call it buffer 6.40. Okay. We are going to do the same thing with our acid and our base solution. So I want to mix it up well, make sure there's no fingerprints, and place our solution into the light source. I'm going to click collect and stop, and I'm going to rename this one acid. All right, one more to go. So we're going to take our base. Again, we're going to mix it up well, make sure there's no fingerprints. Put it into our spectrophotometer, choose collect and stop, rename this one base. All right, now we have the option to put all three of these spectra onto the same graph. Okay. And we want to choose a point by sliding our row along. We're going to choose a point where all three of the indicators have a sufficient absorbance. And we're going to use those three data points to do the calculations to figure out the pKa of our unknown indicator. here is what our graphs look like. So over acidic. Acidic peak, the buffer, and our basic peak.